And Jim, you always share great information. It has nothing to do with just trying to make a sale. It's always information that is topical right now and something that we should know more about.
Well, thank you. And the most topical aspect of family law today was on last Friday, the United States Supreme Court accepting a number of appeals relative to the same-sex marriage debate.
Never hear anything about that.
Not at all. Not at all. If you remember around here, this is a Prop 8 valley, probably a Pro 8 valley, which did pass and went down in the Windsor case, which was, it was interesting because the lawyers on the case were David Boies and Ted Olson, who were adversaries in Bush versus Gore. So if you look at the record of the Windsor case, it was perfectly done. They laid out such a bulletproof case for appeal, so much so that when it was appealed, nobody knew whether or not the losing party or the party who did appeal it even had standing to have the case heard. And it did eventually make its way to the United States Supreme Court, where they affirmed the Ninth Circuit Court of Appeal, which basically struck down Proposition 8 here in California, and that's why we have same-sex marriage here.
All right. So obviously something you're hearing a lot about in the news today, and I love that you kind of help us clarify these things, what it really means and how it came about, and more about it than other than how it's sensationalized.
Well, the real interesting thing here is the United States Supreme Court is really very political. If you look throughout history in their decisions, sometimes their decisions are rather shocking, surprising. But then when you consider the politics of the day and age, they're not so much out of twist with, what would otherwise be expected at the time. So setting up into this one of the things that the court has to deal with has been probably over the last 18 months, just an unbelievable tidal wave of acceptance of same-sex relationships, and that it's possibly time to, you know, accept them. I think it's 36 states that do have same-sex marriage.
And that's happened relatively fast.
Very fast. I mean, really speaking in times of things, it seems to be happening very fast. So the setup in this case is going to be very interesting. As you know, we have a divided Supreme Court, as we have like a divided Congress. So we have four players that are clearly on the right, and we have four players that are clearly on the left, and then we have Justice Kennedy, who is often referred to as the swing vote in these close cases that are typically decided by a majority of five versus a minority of four. And we've had some precedent in going into this. So what the court is dealing with is appeals from cases that have upheld same-sex marriage, have struck down any barriers against it, which is the vast tidal wave of most of the lower courts, the appellate courts, with the exception, I believe, of the Sixth Circuit Court of Appeal that has decided that a ban on same-sex marriage is fine and constitutional. So the court has accepted a number of cases for review, and quite interesting, is laid out basically a couple of questions. So you would think that this is like a individual rights question, right?
Do I,
as this person, have this right? Well, no, that's not the first question that the court wants to know. The court wants to know, is it a state's right issue?
Yeah, and you hear that right. A lot. Yeah, that's the big battle.
This is a big decision. You have those on the right who are the sometimes referred to as originalists. You know, like, we don't want to expand the Constitution. We just want to interpret it, you know, as it was constructed by the authors, the framers. And they're very heavily in favor of protecting the rights of the states. So it is entirely possible on one issue with respect to whether or not a same-sex marriage is going to be valid in any particular state may be left up to the decision of the state. So like a lot of the reporters and everybody that are like talking about these cases, you know, are saying, well, the United States Supreme Court is finally going to decide whether or not as a nation we have same-sex marriage. And that's not necessarily true.
So they're ultimately trying to figure out whether the states are going to have the individual rights. And then, you know, that's something that could have economic influence as well into the state. So that's going to play into it if the states do have the ability to decide, because they could say we do or we don't for monetary reasons.
Well, exactly. I mean, because recognition of same-sex relationships could cost the state more in the form of recognizing the benefits that are provided to couples, filing joint tax returns, health insurance coverage, and things like that. So that becomes, you know, one issue is whether or not the states actually have the right to go ahead and determine who can and who cannot get married. The second issue that comes down, and again, an entirely possible result, we won't know until, you know, much later in the year, or at the end of the next term, whether or not, let's say, a state has the right to determine that a marriage can only be between a man and a woman. What does the state do when a legally married same-sex couple relocates to their state?
Oh, spicy, very spicy. All right, if you're just tuned into the Don and Gino Real Estate Finance Show, and we're here with Jim Reap, with Reap Rickett, Attorneys at Law, one of our favorite guests, and always a wealth of knowledge and fun, because these fun facts, but this is serious stuff that's going on nationally now, and it could be affecting us statewide. We're talking about same-sex marriage and how a lot of new laws have been passed, and then there's an appeal that went through, and we're going through some of the details of how that affects us here in California and how it affects you and everyone else across nationally. Jim, we appreciate you kind of going into more details for this and why it's so important to all of us.
No, it's going to become exceedingly important. And as Gino had pointed out, you know, there's real dollars that are on the line. And it's going to be interesting for me anyway as a lawyer to basically read the ultimate decisions, because certain statements made by some justices in prior cases are going to be hard to wiggle out from under, or how they will reconcile some previous decisions. I want to talk about, remember the day and age? Well, Gino doesn't, but there was a day and age where some states prohibited interracial marriage.
All right. Well, good stuff. You're going to want to stay tuned, because Jim Reap with Reap Rickett, Attorneys at Law, going in deep about what's going on around the country regarding same-sex marriage. We'll be right back to the Don and Gino Real Estate Finance Show on your hometown station, AM 1220 KHS. Don't go away.